Zane is hysterically funny, extremely sarcastic, which is really funny. He's got a great personality. He's got so many aspects to him. He loves so many different things, from music to now he's into weather, and you know, he's just a typical boy. He loves Nerf and swings and playing with his friends, and he's fun to be around. Zane actually hit all his milestones on time as far as crawling and that kind of stuff. Walking was a little late, and he started, you know, the mama and dada and those types of words and sounds were correct. But when he started at 13 months, started walking, then all verbal stopped. So, and it kind of first, the pediatrician kind of just said that it was just going to be, sometimes boys do that. It's just kind of natural. Sometimes they concentrate on one thing at a time and they're more physical than verbal like girls. And so we kind of waited a little bit, and when the word still didn't come, then we called in speech therapy, and then that's kind of started the whole ball rolling of, you know, seeing what's going on in therapies. And originally, because he was in therapy for so long, he was in therapy for a while, they diagnosed him with sensory integration disorder. But because Zane was so social, they really at first were not looking at autism until he had a really good teacher when he was four, who had worked with autistic kids for almost 20 years, and she said, there's no question. And she helped me push to get the testing done, and he was, some words didn't come again until he was probably 3 and a half. We just kept on with the speech therapy, and they would just keep working with him. But when we bought a guitar and brought it home one day, and he just started, we told him to say mama, and he strummed mama, and then it was like, oh my gosh, he's talking. So then the next word, dada, he strummed dada, and it was just, then that's what began speech for him. When Zane was in kindergarten was the first time Vocal Trash came to his elementary school. Of course, he loved it. It really kind of draws you in, the music, because, and that's what it does with the autistic kids, the beat, the sound, that just kind of brings them in. And it, even though it looks like it's amping up, it really kind of calms him down. He would just show up in his little outfit, and they would recognize him and kind of call him on stage, and it just kind of grew from there. And then when we couldn't find a suit and his other little suit was falling apart, Kelsey sent one of her old suits, and we had it fitted for Zane, and he wore his Kelsey suit forever. That just set us into motion for everything that's followed.
My name is Kelsey Ray. I am a co-owner of Vocal Trash. We are an environmental activist show that travels around the world promoting the message of peace, of love, of saving our planet, and inspiring from coast to coast. We met Zane, I remember him specifically. It was a school that we did, and he was in the front row, and I'll never forget it, honestly. And we brought him up on stage. He was wearing a blue jumpsuit, and we gave him a trash can, and he went crazy on the can, and then we really grew into this serious friendship with him and his family.
I could tell when I first saw Zane that there was a little spirit in there that was remarkable. And I could tell that it was one that was somewhat hidden, having a hard time getting it out, but he did. And over the years, we have seen that spirit grow and grow, and the ease of him communicating what he feels inside has been easier and easier and better and better, and we have definitely seen him blossom.
We always bring Zane up on stage because he's an amazing drummer. I mean, he started off great, but now he's really grown into a true performer, so it's exciting to have him as part of the show. Zane now is a drummer at his middle school, which is a really hard seat to fill. They don't pick a lot of drummers, and he has progressed over this amount of time. For about 6 years now, he's really focused on drums, and he made a drum chair at his middle school. I learned from Zane's mom that now the statistic is 1 in 59 children live with autism, and something that I think needs to be aware to everyone around us is that they're not any different than any other kid. They just have a different way of communicating, and sometimes I think we judge people before we even know that the book that they have inside of them. And if we weren't so quick to to think, oh, that kid's weird, or he's not speaking yet, so he's different. Because honestly, we all have the same heart, we all have the same soul, and we're all in this together. So if the judging could stop and maybe get to know an autistic kid instead of judging them first, I feel like sky's the limit.
Zane's doing really well. You have good and bad days, but just like every kid, every 11-year-old boy, he's doing really well. Yeah, I mean, with Zane's personality and people backing him and being around him, you know, I don't know what he's gonna do in life. Don't know if it's gonna be music. Don't know, but I do know it's gonna be something big and something special, just because he's just that kid. There's just something. He's just got it.